Welcome back to sports. I'm Alexandra Ramsey, and starting off with some soccer, it wouldn't be a final without Spain. Just after halftime, that's Neymar there, 45th minute. His fourth goal of the tournament, wide open on the left flank, fires the ball up for 90, giving Brazil the 2-0 lead. Brazil goes on to win 3-0.
The Tigers have been hot all season long, winning 10 of their last 12 games. So I sat down with some of the players to find out just what their secret was.
How about some baseball? Well, even the professionals can't wait to bat. Take a look at this Giants game against the Dodgers Saturday night.
Tons of excitement with the Back the Buzz campaign, but even more exciting, Cody Zeller's performance in Summer League as a top-scoring rookie. With teammates like Michael Kidd-Gilchrist and Jeff Taylor, the future looks promising for the Bobcats. Panthers start training camp this week, all in preps for August 9th, right here against Chicago. We'll see how Cam and the rest of the crew measure up with the toughest schedule in the NFL. From Bank of America Stadium, I'm Alexandra Ramsey.
You say you'd do anything for your kids, but would you really do this?
And eating a piece of cake isn't something you do every day.
Definitely not.
I'm CN2's Alex Ramsey. More with Lauren Chilowinski right after this.
I've got my Zen on.
But do you?
I'm CN2's Alex Ramsey. Join me as I highlight family activities you can do at the Ant Springs Greenway all summer long. From bangers and mash to a little smack talk to the big game Friday night, I'm CN2's Alex Ramsey sitting down with two players from Rock Hill's very own new professional soccer team.
Technology is everywhere, especially education. I'm CN2's Alex Ramsey. Find out how this school is moving from the books to the iPads. Young girls at Bridge Mill Dance Studio twirl and point their toes, rehearsing for their recital this Friday. But the stars may just be their dads.
She knows dance and she wants to go with dad.
Dads will take to the stage for a finale performance with their daughters. It's dance teacher Shaunette Marsh's way of getting these dads involved.
I just send out an email, any dad that wanted to give it a try, and I had 15 brave dads sign up.
Signing up took a lot of outside encouragement.
I was forced to. Another dad in the group, he threw me in his truck and made me come with him.
My wife. Definitely my wife. I didn't have a choice.
Dance, twirl.
And dancing to fast-paced music will get your heart rate going.
I think the first thing the dads didn't realize is how much athleticism it takes. Those dads walk out of there sweaty and breathing hard, and they've worked so hard. And I don't think they realize how hard their daughters work every single week.
They've gotten so good, they even taught me a thing or two. But when asked who is better, well, clearly, it's the true dancers.
Because I have a nicer dance than her.
But for these dads, it's more than just learning dance moves.
Brought us closer because it's something we can do together. You know, as a parent, you're always striving to find something that you can do together and have fun and, you know, that you have a little bit of things, something in common. This is something we can talk about at the dinner table.
Something they can discuss at the dinner table and bond with for a lifetime.
I can see them on their wedding days, and it's not going to be so, you know, so nerve-wracking to get out there with their daddies and dance on their wedding day.
Dancing their way to memories. In Indian Land, Alex Ramsey, CN2 News.
There is a new type of exercise that's supposed to shake up the boring routine in your gym. Alexandra Ramsey joins us to show us a class that teaches you what? Self-defense while it gets you in shape.
It does. Donna, Krav Maga is used overseas as military training in some countries, and now it's catching on here as a way to both defend yourself and get in shape.
A workout that's been sprouting up all over the U.S. is taking the boredom out of the gym by putting you in life or death situations. It's called Krav Maga.
Krav Maga classes are going to incorporate the kickboxing, but at the end of it, we always incorporate a self-defense move where we're going to actually teach you how to use those strikes.
You may have fake guns pointed at you. Learn headlocks or knee chops. The material is new in each class, all without jeopardizing the basic techniques.
In a normal Krav Maga class, you learn to fight off your attacker, and the best part is it's an entire body workout.
This is a combat system. There is nothing pretty or artsy about combat. Combat is gritty, it's cruel, it is straight to the point, and that's what Krav Maga is.
Part of the Israeli Defense Forces system, Krav Maga is Israel's martial art for the military.
Part of their culture is almost every man, woman, and child learns Krav Maga. You don't walk on the streets without understanding Krav Maga, or therefore you would be a victim.
And the health benefits are endless.
I've got students that after 4 or 5 months of training have lost an average of 35 pounds to some of them have lost 80 pounds. I have one student in particular who has had heart problems and cholesterol issues whose doctor has now taken him off of all medications due to the fact that he has leveled himself back out.
You can take classes at their gym on North Harrells Ferry. Mondays through Saturdays, classes start as early as 10 a.m. and run as late as 9 p.m.
Coach, thanks so much for your time. Let's go back to Alex with LSU's star goalkeeper.
Thanks, Garrett. I'm here with senior goalkeeper Megan Kinneman. Megan, you're a veteran on the team now. Talk a little bit about your role on the team this season.
On today's edition of the OT, we'll look at LSU sand volleyball. Plus, we'll introduce a new intense indoor workout. But first, we remember Paul Dietzel. And sticking to the hardwood, the New Orleans Pelicans continued preseason play last night, traveling to Dallas to take on the Mavericks. In the second half, the Mavs started to pull away, but here Jay Crowder gets the block on Austin Rivers, runs cross court, and nails the three-point shot. Mavs now leading 67-62. But in the fourth quarter, it was all Brian Roberts. He scored all 17 of his points in the fourth quarter alone, including the game winner with 21 seconds left. Final score, Pelicans 94, Mavericks 92.
Do you think I could score 3 goals on you?
Three out of 3, I don't know. It'll be tough. It'll be tough.
Ready?
Oh, that was a good